What I want to talk about here is the operations part. There are a number of questions that need to be answered when assessing operations. In such a dynamic, global and complex supply chain in which a large amount of new data is generated every day, we cannot rely on models that are parameterized and trained using outdated data. To make sure that our models will be able to identify emerging risks, we need frequently to parameterize and retrain the prediction models with updated datasets. The frequency of the update depends on how dynamic the input data is. When should we use new data and compare the selected algorithm with other options? If necessary, how can a model be retrained or reparameterized? What about the expert's knowledge that comes from the users? How can human experience and real-life expertise feed the prediction model by correcting all validating predictions? How does the algorithm incorporate such input? Which are the visual dashboards and interface modalities that can be used? Having in place updated prediction models and automation will create predictions that can be a key input for the decision making. Taking the wrong decision means that either unnecessary and expensive lab tests will take place for raw material or ingredients, looking for hazards that we shouldn't really be looking for, or we will miss performing a test for an important emerging hazard for our ingredients or raw materials, and it may go unnoticed under our food risk monitoring procedures. Stay tuned for specific examples for the dairy industry as well as for the chocolate industry. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to our weekly food safety intelligence newsletter to stay up to date with the latest industry news. Find the link below the video.